Hello, I'm Terence, an associate professor and undergraduate program coordinator in the Department of Chemical and Biological Engineering, CBE, at HKUST. I'm now at the CBE Teaching Lab on our campus. This space is just one example of how we support our students' hands-on and co-curricular learning experiences. Let me take the opportunity to tell you more about our undergraduate programs. Our programs aim to equip students with the skills and knowledge to become leaders in the field of chemical and biological engineering. Chemical and biological engineers use their understanding of molecular transformations and physical models to design processes and products. They transform raw materials into high-value products through innovative, effective, and environment-friendly approaches. Whether it's developing new healthcare solutions, creating sustainable energy sources, or addressing global environmental challenges, our engineers are at the forefront of innovation. To give you a clearer picture, let us share some examples of the exciting research happening in our department.
To fight against COVID-19, Professor King Lun Young's research team collaborates with Chiapua Industries to develop a multi-level antimicrobial polymer coating. This MAP1 coating is effective in killing viruses, bacteria, and even hard-to-kill spores. MAP1 can inactivate up to 99.9% of highly infectious viruses such as measles, mumps, and rubella, and 99.99% of the surrogate feline Calissa virus, a gold standard for disinfection efficiency, and is more resistant than coronaviruses such as the one responsible for COVID-19 epidemic. Professor Luo's group's current research focuses on the chemistry and diverse applications of graphene and two-dimensional materials. Their exploration encompasses the utilization of 2D materials in pivotal fields such as biomedical engineering, energy storage, and conversion, as well as electronic and optoelectronic applications. Transitioning to their breakthroughs in sodium-ion battery technology, they are dedicated to unraveling the mechanisms pertinent to reversibility. Through a pioneering hydrogel embedding approach, they have successfully confined few-layer SNS2 nanosheets within a matrix of nitrogen and sulfur-doped carbon nanotubes and amorphous carbon, culminating in the development of a battery design capable of storing 3 times more energy than conventional lithium-ion batteries. Additionally, they are actively engaged in advanced research on hemoperfusion. Traditional hemoperfusion absorbent exhibits inefficiency, sluggish absorption rates, and a host of undesirable side effects. Their research has led to the creation of a novel material tailored for direct hemoperfusion, with a primary objective of revolutionizing the treatment landscape for kidney dysfunction. Furthermore, Professor Luo's team leverages semiconducting materials to drive advancements in energy and electronic device applications. Professor Kim's research group is developing all-solid-state batteries that can meet industry standards. Specifically, the group is designing and synthesizing solid electrolytes that can be utilized in next-generation batteries, including lithium metal, lithium sulfur, sodium, zinc, and multi-ion batteries. These batteries have passed fire and pressure tests, demonstrating higher performance levels compared to conventional liquid-based batteries. Additionally, they facilitate fast charging while maintaining safety standards. The group has also filed numerous patents and is collaborating with industry partners such as CATL. With the widespread use of mRNA vaccine to protect the world from COVID, nucleic acid medicine is already a reality nowadays with the promise to cure many life-threatening diseases. But do you know that biomaterial is critical to package and deliver DNA and RNA so that they can become a viable therapy for patients? Professor Ying Chao's lab is synthesizing designer peptides to self-assemble with DNA and RNA into nano-sized virus-mimicking carriers for this purpose. In another project, her group takes inspiration from cell biology to create biomaterials that can spontaneously form droplets that allow for cell-free production of biologics. Her lab is also interested in developing hydrogel microparticles and nanoparticles for immunotherapy. These particles act like artificial cells to present customized signals for boosting the immune system to kill cancer cells on one hand, while taming the overactive immune response to treat autoimmune disease on the other hand. Professor Chow's research is being commercialized in award-winning startup companies based in Hong Kong and Shenzhen. Professor Yilin Nain's research team works on the development of new wearable devices. For example, sweat is an attractive fluid for health monitoring. It contains biomolecules such as electrolytes, metabolites, hormones, and proteins, which can potentially be detected by wearable devices. She developed state-of-the-art patches that can continuously measure key components in sweat for real-time health monitoring. The success of such research depends on deep understanding of device fabrication, bioanalytic measurements, and the relation between sweat composition and health. Bioengineers are uniquely trained to tackle these integrated problems. Professor Becky Kwong's research is another nice example of how bioengineers are improving healthcare around the world. She harnesses the power of biology to solve urgent biomedical problems. For example, her team has developed a synthetic messenger RNA molecule with exceptional good biocompatibility and stability to control living cells. These molecules can ultimately be used in clinical settings for cellular therapeutics, tissue engineering, and regenerative medicine. Students at CBE are strongly encouraged to engage in research and delve into the mysteries of materials, energy, the environment, healthcare, and beyond. Research opportunities abound, whether through collaboration with our distinguished professors or partnerships with laboratories abroad. CBE students also exhibit immense enthusiasm for experiential learning projects, entrepreneurship, and competitive events. In recent years, our students have garnered notable success in HKUST's most esteemed competitions, securing more awards than any other department. During the COVID-19 pandemic, CBE students developed a long-lasting antimicrobial hand cream in their product and process design course. With support from the department and an alumna entrepreneur, the idea was successfully commercialized. CBE students are dedicated to environmental conservation and waste reduction. One example is Smart Fish Model for real-time detection of microplastics. It received the Championship of Best Final Year Environmental Project from HKIE Environmental Division. Another example in waste reduction is the repurposing of retired electric vehicle batteries for stationary use, which received the runner-up in the AICHE Chemical for Good Challenge. CBE students innovate new technologies and actively bring them to the market, creating a significant impact on the community. These products often excel in competitions and seminars, receiving recognition from esteemed institutions like the Hong Kong Food Council and the Macau Catering Organization. Many of these projects evolve into incubatees at the Hong Kong Science and Technology Park, further solidifying their contributions to the entrepreneurial landscape. Our students consistently excel in a multitude of regional, national, and international competitions hosted by prestigious organizations such as the Hong Kong Institution of Engineers, the National Challenge Cup, and the American Institute of Chemical Engineers. CBE offers three programs: chemical engineering, bioengineering, and energy and environmental engineering. Chemical engineering involves transforming raw materials into valuable products that people use every day, from sun cream to chocolate to pharmaceuticals. This profession combines knowledge of chemistry, physics, biology, mathematics, and natural science to produce products that improve our living quality, provide us clean and affordable energy sources, reduce pollutant emissions from manufacturing processes, clean up our environment, and many more. Bioengineering is the bridge between basic life sciences and engineering. It combines the solid foundations of basic and applied sciences with the analytical, quantitative, and design skill set required of engineers. Most importantly, bioengineers are called upon to leverage their knowledge to solve real-world problems, many of which are among the grand challenges of the 21st century. This program is designed to prepare students for career opportunities in local and regional industries in pharmaceuticals and biomedical devices, biosensors, healthcare analytics, and biotechnology and healthcare products. The sustainable production and use of energy and the protection of the environment are among the greatest challenges of our time. Energy and environmental engineers design and implement engineering solutions to provide energy to sustain modern societies while minimizing the impact on our environment. Their expertise is also needed in various industries, including energy storage and conversion, energy-intensive manufacturing, waste management, pollution control, and environmental impact assessment. Beyond academic excellence, CBE students are encouraged to pursue all-round development through a range of co-curricular opportunities. Our students are supported in joining exchange programs to broaden their perspectives. They also undertake industry internships, engage in cutting-edge research, and participate in industrial site visits, conferences, and prestigious competitions, deepening their technical knowledge and honing professional abilities. By integrating these diverse co-curricular elements, the CBE department nurtures graduates who are adaptable, globally minded, and possess the real-world skills. To encourage students to apply academic learning to real-world problems, the CBE department secures a wide range of internship and co-op opportunities from local and international industry partners. Our students have access to tens of partnered companies across diverse sectors, allowing them to gain hands-on experience and explore potential career paths. Most CBE students take advantage of these immersive programs and praise the practical experience. The ability to apply classroom knowledge to real-world challenges gives students a significant edge, equipping them with the problem-solving mindset and technical expertise sought after by leading employers. By integrating industry partnerships, the CBE department ensures smooth transitions from academia to the professional world upon graduation. In today's era of artificial intelligence, CBE programs can be enhanced by incorporating AI components. In the bioengineering program, students need to complete an additional 13 credits to earn a bachelor's degree in bioengineering plus AI. For chemical engineering and energy and environmental engineering programs, students must complete 22 to 26 credits to obtain their respective bachelor's degrees with the AI extension. Below, we will showcase the AI-related research conducted by our faculty members. Cancer is a process of clonal evolution with patients suffering from cell growth out of control. Current treatment methods, including chemotherapy and radiotherapy, typically eliminate most of the cancer cells to extend patient survival. However, many refractory tumors recur in a more aggressive form, leading to patient death. Professor Jiguang Wang's group leverages big data technologies to characterize cancer cells based on multi-omics for precision diagnosis and treatment. They hope to develop molecular diagnosis and deliver targeted therapies to treat previously incurable cancers. Nowadays, for cancer patients who need to go through a surgical excision of tumor, we have to rely on frozen section in order to provide an intraoperative feedback to medical doctors whether he or she did a good cut. While this procedure is relatively fast, which only takes around 30 minutes, the accuracy is not as high as the post-operative pathologic assessment. In about a week, the post-operative assessment will be done. If it shows that there is any remaining tumor, second surgery will be needed to remove all the remaining tumor. Here, Professor Terence Wong's group propose a novel imaging technology named CHAMP microscope. With this new imaging tool, they are able to show high-quality test results that are almost equivalent to the post-operative assessment to pathologists in just 3 minutes. With compared with frozen section, CHAMP is 10 times faster, from 30 minutes to just 3 minutes, and more accurate, from 65% to 90% plus. In the future, it is also possible to have the integration of AI to make an assistive medical diagnosis, further improving the efficiency in the healthcare system. With CHAMP, it is then possible to say no to lengthy sample preparations, inaccurate test results, and second surgeries due to positive surgical margin. Machine learning can be used to effectively accelerate material and synthesis design. Using machine learning techniques, researchers can develop unprecedented capabilities to predict molecular and materials properties and significantly shorten the trial and error cycles in traditional experimental workflows. For example, there are millions of proteins with known sequences but unknown structures. Professor Hanyu Gao's team can use machine learning to predict structure-related features and identify desired proteins in the protein universe. This example on the left shows their effort to identify entangled protein chains that have superior stability. In organic chemistry, they can use machine learning to learn the complex structure and bonding relationships. With these models, they can search for synthetic pathways for complex molecules, recommend reaction conditions, and predict the outcomes of organic synthesis. These provide strong support to small molecules synthesis, which is widely used in pharmaceutical, agricultural, and other chemical industries. There are abundant opportunities for our graduates, one of which includes pursuing postgraduate studies. Our graduates are exceptionally competitive and have gained admission to numerous top universities worldwide. Here are a few representative examples. On the industry front, our students have embarked on diverse career paths in a range of companies, spanning environmental consulting, biotech startups, safety management, and government offices. Here are some examples for your reference. For further details, please visit our website by scanning the QR code provided. You can also explore our updates on Instagram. Feel free to contact Professor Terence Wong via email for any inquiries.
By now, I hope you have a better understanding of our undergraduate programs and impactful research. For more information, please visit our website and feel free to reach out with any questions. If you are passionate about making a difference in our society through your talents and contributions, we look forward to welcoming you to HKUST soon.